They used to draw.
Hello, art family, and thank you to everyone who subscribed recently. I wanted to do a video on a very common request I get, which is what the pochade situation is that I'm using in various videos or Instagram posts. I get a lot of questions about that. I get a lot of questions about the homemade watercolor box and gouache box that I've made. So I'm eventually going to do one on designing and building your own metal boxes, but that's a little more complex, and I'm trying to get further along in the book I'm working on, so. A pochade box comes from the French word pochade for pocket box. It's the box that you would take out into the field to do field sketching. I've tried to organize these examples in terms of complexity. So they'll start with the simple one. That's not even a box, really. It's just a sheet of plywood. But I want to talk about that and the tools you use, because I think a lot of people are intimidated by having no experience or having no tools. Really, all you need is a drill and a hammer, probably, and some wood finish. But you can get by with that. If you go to Home Depot or any place that has wood, usually they have saws, and usually they'll cut it to size for you. So I'm trying to make this video as accessible as possible at any level that you're comfortable with. The first example is as practical and utilitarian as possible, and almost one of the most useful and easy to carry, really. And that's just a sheet of plywood. 1/4 plywood, or even thinner, that you can get at Home Depot or wherever. And you just take that plywood, and what I did was I got one of my sketchbooks that I carry often, and I've done a couple of these sheets of plywood just to have them for various sketchbook sizes. And you open that sketchbook up and you get that measurement of the open sketchbook, and then you can, if you don't have a saw, you could go to Home Depot or a place that has a saw, or bug someone and get that sheet of plywood cut, and then install a T-nut in the center of the board. The T-nut is what screws into a tripod, and you need a 1/4-20 T-nut you could get on Amazon or at a Home Depot. And what you do is get a bit. You could ask a Home Depot or Lowe's employee to find the right bit for the perfect size. You drill that in the middle of the board, put wood glue around it, and you tap the T-nut into it. Then finish the board with a clear coat. These are the clamps I use to attach my sketchbook. The next example, and sticking with the super, super simple, is the cigar box. And I mean literally a cigar box. These things are beautifully made. The joinery is really nice. They usually have a nice latch and hinge system on them. And they're at any local cigar shop. And you can get on Google and find some near you. And they just discard these boxes after they put their cigars on display. So if you go to a cigar shop, they usually have these things just stacked. And they sell them for like $1 or $2. I've been using this one as a pencil box, but with, you know, I could attach something to sturdy up the lid as it, and hold it out, or put something on the back like cork so that it sits on it. But with just a little adaptation, this would make a really nice pochade box. You could also put a T-nut in the bottom of it too. This next box I use the most, and I get the most questions about it, and that's my quote unquote Gurney easel. It's called a Gurney easel because the concept came from the artist James Gurney, who is an avid planner painter. And if you're watching this, you probably already know who he is and have seen all his videos. But he came up with this open source kind of concept where it's a very simple design, but it's like a constant prototype. You can just do anything with this thing. And I'm always adapting it and changing it. And I recently installed magnets in mine. And I'm not really comfortable talking about how it's built specifically, because he has a tutorial, which I'll link to, that he has on his Gumroad that goes through exactly how to build it piece by piece. So if you really want to build one, you can check that out. But they're very, very simple. Again, you could get the wood cut for you at Home Depot or any wood shop, and just order the pieces. It's very simple to put together and even adapt and change and add on to or customize. I've seen all different manner of changes people have made with things that fold out or, you know, attach to it. Or Gurney himself has like a diffuser that attaches to the top. The strength of this box really is that you put the T-nut on the top where you draw, and that makes it much better than other pochade boxes I've used, because you're actually drawing against the tripod, so you get a much sturdier surface with this one. This next one is an actual pochade box that I designed myself, and I did it by looking at various pochade boxes that I liked and kind of making my own notes and ideas. And these little things that hold the box open are just pieces you can buy at Home Depot. It's just wing nuts and some bolts and these little metal strips that have holes in them that I got all of this stuff at Home Depot. So you can get all this just at the hardware store. And I put these additional back strips so that the box has something to sit on, and installed a T-nut on the bottom. And this is really simple. It looks more complex than it actually is. What it is just plain plywood. And then on the outside of it, all of that is square dowels. So that's just, if you go to Home Depot and you see the round dowels, there's also square dowels. So I just took those square dowels and I cut them to length, and then I wood glued this thing together and popped in some screws to hold it. At Lowe's, they'll cut plastic, acrylic plastic for you, and I got some cut to the right size and I spray painted the back white and then installed that on the inside. I had pre-cut some slots on the plywood, and I even glued in a little lip so that it would have a sketchbook would have something to sit on. But it has these slots, which I kind of stole from an idea I saw online, that you can take bungee cords and sort of hook them through the slot onto the canvas board or sketchbook that you're using. This last one is actually really complex, and it's made the same way as the one before this was made. It's very simple. All with hardware I got at Home Depot and wood I got at Home Depot. It's just a little bit fancier, kind of required a little bit more finesse in terms of gluing and clamping and doweling together. It's the same thing with the plywood. I got a piece of plywood, and then they sell strips of wood that are 1 inch by, 2 inches or 1 inch or 3 inch. And I got some of those, and I just sort of built a little box that I then hinged together with brass hinges, and all these little pieces I got, like the corners and the latches, were all there. The handle for this box was actually from a discarded French easel I found in an alley back in Virginia that I just sort of took some of the pieces off of and got rid of the rest. It's held open by this door latch, or I think it's been called a stop, or it's made for drawers or cabinets to hold it open at a certain place. So just with a little bit of adaptation, I was able to bend it and kind of get it to fit on this box so that it sits flush on the side. Sitting on the front of this box, and I was trying to do this in a sort of reverse of a pochade box, so you're drawing on the top of the box. I kind of took that idea from the Joseph Spukvik box that he uses, where he draws on the lid facing the away from you. I took this idea from Open Box M, which are these little shelves that are attachable by some screws I put on the bottom. The screw hangs down and then is attached with a nut on the inside. So there is like a quarter inch screw on the bottom, but these shelves have been really handy to stick pallets on, or to rest my tools on, or whatever, paper towel or things I need. I cut the slots on this one for the bungee cord idea if I'm working in oil and I want a smaller canvas or thing or board to work on. But I mainly use this for blocks of arches or sheets of arches that I can just tape to it. The biggest mistake I made with this one was I made it with red oak, and so it's a little bit heavy. So that's it for this demonstration of some homemade pochade solutions. It's really up to you whether or not you feel like it's worth it. There are all manner of pochades on sale online for upwards of, $500, $600, or some cheaper. But, you could make something homemade, you could get away with just a board. It just depends on your comfort level and how you like to work. I hope you found something inspiring, or helpful at least. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me on social media or on here in the comments, and I'd be happy to help you in any way I can. And I suppose I'll see you in the next video, but in the meantime, happy sketching.